When you're considering SDK buffering, there's a couple limitations to note. So first of all, if you have a client node and you're sending to a PI server, and you want to send to a second PI server, remember that if you switch over, the PI Buffer subsystem won't buffer data to the new server. It can only be configured to send to a single server at a time. And if you want it to buffer to a second one, you'll need to reconfigure and restart the PI Buffer subsystem. It can only buffer to one server or collective at a time. Next, if you're writing to the same PI tag from multiple different nodes, you'll need to be sure to do it with the PI Buffer subsystem on all nodes. If you're writing with the PI Buffer subsystem from one node, but from another one you're not, that you can possibly get into a point lock scenario, where the PI server will grant a point lock to writing to this tag to the PI Buffer subsystem, and any other nodes that attempt to write to that tag will be denied access. We don't want that, so it's important that the PI Buffer subsystem is used on all nodes that are writing to the same tag if you decide to configure SDK buffering. Now, usually, the PI Buffer subsystem will be buffering API-only data or SDK-only data. And there's some scenarios where both will be sent from the same node. Now, we recommend this configuration where you're using the PI Buffer subsystem to send both the API and the SDK data simultaneously. Now, it's possible that some folks out there have PI Buffer server, the old buffering strategy we have, to send the API data while SDK data is just sent unbuffered. And they might be tempted just to put in the PI Buffer subsystem to buffer that SDK data. However, this is not a supported configuration. The PI Buffer server and the PI Buffer subsystem can't run at the same time. If you want to buffer both of these streams of data, you'll need to install the PI Buffer subsystem and have it handle both the API and the SDK data. Next, let's look at some fanning things. So, we can set up the PI Buffer subsystem now to fan SDK data to a collective. Now, if you have a mobile device that has unpredictable or limited connectivity to a network, there can be quite a load on the network if you're trying to fan to a collective, especially a big and distributed collective. So we don't recommend putting in fanning of SDK data from devices that are going to be on and off of the network a lot. Instead, it's better just to write to one server or the other.